Good evening, good evening, good evening, everybody. This is Pastor Jay, and we're going to start off in decency and in order with a scripture and a prayer. And it says in Thessalonians 5 and 6, "So then let us not be like others who are asleep, but let us be awake and sober." God wants us to be aware of our surroundings, not to just fall for anything, banana in the tailpipe, any of the enemy snares, to think that that's how something should go. God has a purpose. God has a reason for you to go through things. So you have to be aware, you have to be awake, and you cannot sleep on anything. Amen. Amen. Dear Father, thank you, God, for this day, God. God, we ask you to just be in the midst of this interview. Let something be said that could bring someone closer to you, Lord. God, let some new revelation appear today, God. God, bless this interview. Bless everyone that's on this interview, God. Let's be able to take out all distractions so that we can be able to talk about your glory, talk about the ministry, and be able to go forth to the people that do not know of you, Lord, or just to even reintroduce some things to you, Lord God. We just thank you for everything that you're doing. We bless you, God. Bless every listener under the sound of my voice, God, that they will be healed, that they'll be delivered, that they'll have a breakthrough come through. God, we thank you. We glorify you. We said it all in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. This is Pastor Jay, and like always, you can find me at Anointed Jaylon on Instagram and Twitter, Jay Calhoun on Facebook. New project coming out October 20th. Wake Up Bless. Yes, I'm actually my new project, Wake Up Bless, coming out on all digital platforms, and you could be able to hear my new song. Go pre-order it, go pre-add it, go all that. But there's some songs already out there. If you want to hear a little taster, go ahead and go get Renew My Praise on all digital platforms. Go ahead and get Jesus, You Make Me Happy. And my album is coming out soon, y'all. I got some great things coming up. And if you didn't know, we're doing distribution. Let me say that one more time. Anointed Radio's doing what? Distribution. Say like Efo, distribution. Ooh. Yeah, I had to say it like distribution, because we are doing distribution for all artists out there that are under our following criteria. So with that being said, make sure that you have Anointed Radio followed. Duh. I had to be dramatic with it. Go follow Anointed Radio on LV, Anointed Radio on all digital platforms, and make sure you download the Anointed Radio app for 24-hour gospel music. Yes, 24-hour gospel music. With that being said, make sure you go follow Chris Johnson. He's not here today. He had church today. Amen. So go follow Chris Johnson at singchrisj.com. Sing Chris J, all social media. And go check out his song, Chasing After You. And he will have some more music coming soon. So keep an eye out on Chris Johnson. With that being said, that's everything. Go ahead, Miss Dr. Clay, ladies first, everybody.
Hey, 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 everyone. Y'all can hear me good?
Yes.
Oh, good, good, good. Been in the midst of some things today. But it's good to be on with you all. This is Dr. Marvinetta Clay. And you all can go and find me on all those social medias. Marvinetta Clay, Clay Marvinetta. Anything you see Marvinetta, I think I'm the only name out there with that, I think. So, but just find me there. You'll see it. Go to my website, drmarvinettaclay.com. Also, you will be hearing some new music coming out. Worship Forever is still out there and it's doing well. I got a chance to minister it this weekend at the Right Market Conference, and it was awesome with all the radio personalities and everyone that was there. Met some wonderful people, connecting with some awesome people. So it's still out there and going to continue to be out there, because it is Worship Forever. We worship forever and God forever until we ain't got no more breath in our body. Amen. Then we cross over, it's still going to worship him. So, amen. And then my next two songs are getting ready to hit soon. Fly Away and, oh, God, what's the song? God is so good. That is right there. Yeah. God is so good. He is good. So look out for that as well. And as you can see behind me, I'm working on my T-shirt line, working on my apparels and different things. I'm so excited what God is doing. I tell you, this pandemic, if it ain't did nothing else, it definitely has took me out of one place and pulled me somewhere I never thought I'd be. So y'all follow me. Got some things getting ready to go on. Also, my apparel line too, worshipforever1.com. God bless.
And for her social media, so we could get her follows up, everybody. Go follow her at Clay Marvinetta. Clay Marvinetta. Go follow her on her social media, Clay Marvinetta. Now, DW. Oh, we can't even hear you. Not yet. Nope. While you handle that, we're gonna go ahead and go to Mr. Will. How you doing, Mr. Will?
What's going on, y'all? Can you hear
me? Yes, we can.
What's happening? How you feeling?
Doing blessed. How are you doing?
Doing really good. Taking it a day at a time.
Okay. And one thing I would just say is thank you. I'm probably tell you thank you again, but I just wanted to first of all say thank you for coming on the show. I know as an artist, a lot of things are moving pieces, especially now with you know this whole pandemic. You got to do a whole lot of things differently. So we definitely appreciate you for coming on. What's your social media so everybody could go follow you, get your follows up?
For sure. And it's funny because I have my cell phone up here and I'm on Instagram Live too. So but my social media, my Instagram is Will McMillan with three I's. My Twitter is The Will M Band. Facebook is Will M Band. And my what else? That's it. That's all three. I was about to say Snapchat, but nobody does Snapchat anymore. So
right. Unless TikTok. Now people go to TikTok.
I'm gonna get one of those too. I'm a little behind with that. So
oh, I'm way behind. I probably never get one of those. So amen. So I would say is if anybody didn't know that Mr. Will, he is a great gospel singer that has some beautiful songs that we're going to be getting into so that you could be able to be introduced into him and know about his music, know a little more about him. And we're going to dig into his background and just know a little more about his story and his testimony. But before that, we're going to see if we get Mr. DW. DW? Nope. Nothing.
Restart. Okay.
We're gonna have you restart and go into the music break and DW come back and we'll reintroduce him when we get to interview. So with that being said, we're gonna go ahead and go into his music and we're gonna start off with Best Things, everybody. So we'll see y'all in a few minutes.
You are the one. Wrote my story. Is that you wrote it on a tree? So Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Oh, who would have thought you'd give up everything? You're the only reason that I'm free. One thing I'll know for sure is that you're always here with me. Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened. Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened. Oh, Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me.
Come on.
Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened. Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened. Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened. Oh, Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened. Oh, Jesus, you're the best thing that ever happened to me. Jesus, you're the best thing, that ever happened. Oh, Jesus, you're the best thing, that ever happened. Oh, Jesus, you're the best thing, that ever happened to me, to me.
This is my testimony. Instead of giving up on me, you make me free. Oh, so I can live out daily what you did for me. My story.
Come on,
Jesus, you're what I had in another way that ever happened.
I know,
Jesus, you're the best thing,
you're the best thing
that ever happened.
Jesus,
you're the best thing
that ever happened to me, to me, to me, that ever happened to me.
Lord, you keep grace.
never leave me. I played around for a while and found life can be no fair.
No fair.
No fair. But grace has a wave creeping up when the odds are just not there. Not there. You looked beyond what I once was, a hopeless tragedy, and stepped in and captured my heart with love, so costly and yet free. I'll still do wrong, you open your arms. Oh, for when I fall, you're there to catch me. And if I fall again, you're there to do the same. Lord, you keep grace around me. You'll never leave me, leave me. For when I fall, you're there to catch me. And if I fall again, you're there to do the same. Lord, you keep your arms around me. You'll never leave me. Now unto you, who is able to keep me from falling. Now unto you, who is able to keep me from falling. Lord, it is you who is able to keep me from falling. Lord, it is you who's able to keep me from falling. When I out my window, I ask myself, what do I see? The sky and land are filled with creatures living in perfect harmony. A reflection of you. so amazing in all that you do. So every day I live my life trying to be more and more like you. That's the way I wanna live. So
when people see me, Lord, let them see you. Me.
Oh, just to be like you. That's the way I wanna live.
When people see me, Lord, let them see you.
All through me.
Living in this world today, things have a tendency to change drastically. You alone remain the same. You never forget about me. You are consistent. You remain the same. All that you do, Lord, you will never change.
Shine your light on me.
So every day I live my life trying to be more and more like you.
Every day I live my life trying to be more and more like you.
So every day I live my life trying to be more and more like you.
Every day I live my life trying to be more like you, more like you.
If we all say,
let people see me, Lord,
Lord, let them see you.
Just to be more like you is the way I wanna live.
Let people see me, Lord, let them see you
through me. I want them to see you.
Let them see you.
When people see me, Lord, let them see you through me.
I've been away for way too long, and failed to consider what was home. Now my desire's to be found lost in your arms. I am asking you to help me find you. In your fullness, help me find my way back to you. Not to where I've been, but even further, to be lost in mountains, my desire. For my desire, I thought that I could go alone. Just take my share and just move on. A misleading option, prodigal. I was wrong. I can't defend my side no more. I chose to run. Now I choose to come back home to find you. In your fullness, help me find my way back to you. Not to where I've been, but even further, to be lost and found with my desire. You were my designer. And I chose to run. Now I choose to come back home. I to take me further to be lost and found in you, my Father. I chose to run. Now I choose to come back home. Is this party for me? The cloud of witnesses. With my Father, they said, with open arms. Oh, it's what they said. Oh, I'm finally here. It's what they said.
Welcome home.
It's what they say.
That was Lost and Found, everybody. That track was grooving. You didn't hear it. It was grooving. So go download Lost and Found, everybody. So in the normal Anointed Radio fashion, we're going to go ahead and start off like always. And I'm going to ask and introduce everybody. Everybody, Will McMillan, everybody. Everybody, reintroducing to some, reintroducing to others. If you was just listening, the man in the flesh, we have him here, y'all. So he, every one of those three songs, Best Things, You'll Never Leave, See You, and Lost and Found, he wrote, made those songs, put them out for you to hear it and to minister your heart. And we're going to go deep into that. But first, we got to do a Pastor J icebreaker question. You ready?
Is this a question for me?
It's yes.
For you. Okay, what's up? What's good?
All right. Icebreaker question is this. If you had to pick one form of, I guess you could say, eating period that you would have to get rid of, breakfast, lunch, or dinner, which one would you get rid of?
Breakfast, hands down.
What?
Yeah, breakfast, yeah. I'm not really a breakfast
person. Important meal of the day.
I know. Is
breakfast. And then they make them good, you know, breakfast foods. Like you can have breakfast food for dinner, lunch, because it's breakfast.
That's the young people, Pastor.
You said that's the young people.
That's the young people.
Only
y'all can hear me now. I'm here live.
Trying to get.
Yes, we can hear you.
I'm sorry, DW, you said something?
No, I was just saying that's the young people, you know, the millennials, they don't eat breakfast.
That's how you, you can know, tell our age. Only reason I say breakfast is because there's not a lot of breakfast foods that, you know, you use without eating bread. And I'm trying to stay away from, like, carbs and stuff. You know what I'm saying? So it's like you have, like, you know, like the hash browns, the French toast, what else? Waffles. There's so much bread. It's just like I can, you know, you can do away with that with lunch and dinner. You know what I'm saying? Not necessarily. Mm-hmm. So that's the only reason. So
okay, now you want to get Dr. Thibbeat on me. Okay, I got you.
Just trying to do a little better, you know.
But I understand. And one thing I guess I could just go ahead and get started with is this. Where is your hometown and where do you reside now?
Yeah, for sure. My hometown is Baltimore, Maryland.
B-more
in the house. Born and raised. Now I live in Prince George's County. Maryland is about an hour away. I've been out here for about really right when the pandemic started. So about 6 months.
Okay. So the question I would ask is this. So growing up, what was the very first ministry you did in church?
Very first ministry I did in church.
The first one you joined that you felt a part of.
Well, music, because I started out on drums.
Okay.
Yeah, music. I was the offering player drummer. You know how, like, you know, the young they used to give the young guys it's like, oh, you can just play offering. That was my first ministry for sure. In the children's choir, okay. Of course, too.
Okay, so what was your very first experience saying that, you know what, this is what I'm called to do? What was that moment for you where you felt like music, right? Doing music is serious for me, and I want to take it to that next level to start recording, to start putting out and start sharing it. What was that experience for you?
Well, it was in different phases because I started out as a church musician. When I really started to, I guess, progress in my playing, the musician that was at my home church left. So I was the only one that was, you know, that was playing at the time. So at 10 years old, I was a main musician for the bishop's church. So I had to learn.
Wow. Right.
And so from then on, it's just been an ongoing, you know, just progression of, you know, in different phases of it. But I would say at a very, very early age, I knew that this was, you know, what I was supposed to do for sure.
Okay. And when you, as being a musician and a singer, I think that's even, it takes a whole different, like hit on you. You know, it hit different when you're a musician and a singer. So when was it the time where you're like, man, I needed to pick one to focus on other than the other? Because a lot of times you have to get to that point where you're like, okay, I really love music, being a musician, but now I got to focus on my singing. Now I love being a singer, but I need to kind of, you know, brush up my skills. So what was that for you during that time? Have you ever had that moment?
Oh yeah, for sure. And it's in the challenge, because I do both, I feel at like around the same, I have to put the same energy towards both now because I'm a assistant band director at, you know, at my church. But then I also, you know, do my artistry. But there was a time when I was traveling for different artists for about, I'd say about 7-8 years time, actually longer than that. But then I came to a place where, God showed me that it was my time to now focus on, you know, completing the songs that was given to me in those, you know, in that amount of time. So the moment did happen, but then it kind of shifted and evolved, you know what I'm saying, to where it's like I wear many hats, you know. So I'm assistant band director here, I'm producing here, and then I'm doing my own thing as well. So I have to kind of shift my thinking, you know, in different times. So
I have to go into this because I know some artists heard in their ears and it perked up. There was like producing. So when you mean producing, you're making some good old music for artists. Am I clear on that? Is that right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. I launched my production company in February, and now I have on my roster right now about 7 artists that I'm working with right now.
Well, can I just interject here really quick, because you're being very humble. Can we just name off a couple of artists that you've worked with? Like, he's not just working with, you know, Shaquanda doing the hand selection. Let's just, so you've worked with Travis Green, yes?
Yeah, I did. I was a music director on his project, Crossover. I was a music director on Pastor William McDowell's record, both of them, Sounds of Revival 1 and 2. I co-wrote the song with him, Send the Rain. That was Dove nominated. I worked on Tasha Cobb's One Place album. I arranged the song Praise on it. Jonathan Nelson, Jason Nelson, and if I'm missing anybody, I'm sorry. But those are like the main. But I traveled with them for years.
So you've been the Teddy Riley for on the gospel side, doing giving that new sound.
Yeah, I mean, for sure. And it's crazy because during that time, that was about like 9 to 10 years time. And all of that, God allowed me to see a lot of what I was going to be doing later. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So although I was serving and although I was, serving with them and serving for them, God was preparing me for what, later would be, for, what I was supposed to be doing. You know what I'm saying?
So I love how you call it serving.
I was going to say that too.
Yeah.
Because.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Oh, ain't no problem. I was just going to say, you don't hear that no more.
Serving. You do. Yeah, you do. You hear from the real people.
The real people.
Yeah.
But it's delighting to hear from a musician.
Amen.
And I just give you that charge that, keep that. Because God going to put you up front of a lot of things because your heart in the right place. So I just had to. I definitely had to say that. But go ahead, DW.
Yeah, well, I was gonna say with being a
servant. And turn up your mic a little bit.
Yes. Okay. Listen. I'm learning. I'm a new interviewer, right? But with you being a servant and doing all of this amazing music, what I really want to know is why be an artist. Hearing you, you've had this amazing, successful career where you don't have to put yourself out there. The music industry has changed so much. And mm-hmm. I remember seeing you last year at the Stellar Awards. You were one of the next upcoming artist. I heard Best Thing. And I was just like, I've never heard Best Thing like that before, though. That was just like dope. But with everything going on, let's be honest, artists fail every day. We see a lot of people who come out into the industry and not only why be an artist, but why be a gospel artist? Like I listen to your music. It has such a, it's reminiscent of PJ Morton. It's
my hero.
Reminiscent of a lot of, yeah. So I want to know, why did you decide to be an artist and why be a gospel artist?
Yeah, well, one of the things was when I first started writing music, and my sister, she's on my feed. I'm putting out a little Facebook Live thing right now too, but she's on here and she could attest to this. We would write songs, and this was when I first realized that I was a writer. I would send them to different people and different artists, and nobody would at that time they wouldn't accept them. I mean, as a songwriter, you're trying to get in the game. Nobody's really taking you serious. It's like, go sit on that keyboard and, shut up somewhere, But one of my mentors now, Anthony Brown, shout out to Anthony Brown. He's a minister, assistant minister of music at my church. Shout out to First Baptist Church of Glen Arm, my pastor, Pastor John K. Jenkins. Love being there and serving there. But he told me, this was years ago, he told me, he's like, because I'm like, bro, nobody's accepting him. And I was low-key trying to tell him, like, yo, I got a song for you. You know what I'm saying? But he's like, bro, how about this? How about you sing it yourself? And I'm like, I ain't really a singer like that. But then it made sense because nobody can really, because it's about getting your songs out there. It was about getting my songs out there, but it was also about, getting a message out there. But nobody can really tell your story how you can. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And so that's really why I started. And then it turned into, wow, I'm really supposed to do this. And, here we are. As I put out the record and ended up on a Stellar Awards, like, I'm like, where did this come from? So, yeah.
Hey, I got to say this while everybody's tuning back in, and I got some people, because I went on IG Live to Mr. Will, because Mr. Will had me sitting here like, why am I not on IG right now on live talking about come to the interview? So if anybody's coming over, just go ahead and just share this video feed. If you're on YouTube, go ahead and post this on your Facebook. Go share. Download the Anointed Radio app. We're about to get into some good stuff. And we're back in the interview. Go ahead, Mr. DW.
So listening to your music, doing my research, and first of all, you're amazing. I want to say I'm a fan. Your tone, your musical choices are absolutely amazing. I'm gonna kind of change it up. I saw your YouTube video. You're still signed with E1, right?
Yep. Shout out to E1. Shout out to E1. Jimmy Miller, Omega, Stan. Oh, y'all, I love y'all. Shout out to
Darnell, all the people over there at E1. Yes. They are pumping out some great artists and really overcoming this pandemic. So when I listen to your song, How Do We Respond, featuring Julia McMillan, now that is your...
That's my sister.
That's your sister, okay. Mm-hmm. I saw a lot of people saying like that BB and CC kind of feel that you guys have. So two questions. Can we expect more BB and CC kind of music, because your sister is absolutely amazing, and off subject, do you feel like we as Christians have responded the right way during this pandemic and everything that's going on?
Man, so which question you want to answer first? The BB and CC?
the BB and CC one.
BB and CC is the easiest one.
So I do foresee us doing a project together. I do, but one of my main assignments that I feel like in the season is to, because she sings background for everybody, you know, she did, I'm not going to start name dropping. She's just the truth. But one of my assignments I feel is to be able to push her into kind of set the stage for, you know, what the world needs to see from her as an individual, you know what I'm saying? So she's working on, you know, some material for herself. And before we do anything together, I feel like I haven't completed, I feel like I wouldn't have completed my assignment, you know, with her if I didn't make sure that she was able to do that for herself. So to answer your question, in the future, yes, but I feel that she'll be more CC before we are BB and CC, you know what I'm saying? So, that's to put in, you know.
Y'all got the magic. I just want to let you know, you guys have the magic, and I'm just putting it out there. I feel like if you did, you all have that magic to do like a really nice single, a hit that you know you can loan me $20 on.
I will also say this. We don't do anything separate. Like even when it comes to like our careers and, you know, serving and singing and playing behind people, everybody that I've mentioned that I've played for, she sang for, like the William McDowell, Sounds of Revival. We both did that record together. Jonathan Nelson, Jason Nelson. I was playing for Travis Green, then they end up connecting and she ended up being his lead vocalist for a long time. So we do everything together. So I agree with you. I believe that when that does happen, it's really gonna mean something for sure.
Yeah. Now the second question, how do we respond? I love the video. I love the essence of it. I love, you know, I don't mean to use the word young people, but I am a little older. So I'd love to see your generation really take that torch and contribute to what's going on right now in this world. But with that being said, do you feel as Christians we've done enough?
You know, this is just my main thing. Because there's a very, okay, so there's two sides of it. There's the human side that we all have, you know, as the Black community, as the even people who aren't necessarily Black but just have a heart, right? Like, this stuff makes us mad and angry, you know what I'm saying? So our initial response, of course, like, if we show that we're upset and angry at the things going on, I do feel that that is okay. There's nothing wrong with that. The only thing is, with the song, you know, and honestly, I'll say I can't really speak for nobody. I can speak for myself. The song really was birthed out of me being upset about an encounter that I had with someone, a white person, who called me a nigger to my face. I don't know if I can say that on here, but did you bleep it out?
I did.
You can say nigger.
Okay, cool.
That's a real word.
He called me a nigger to my face. I went home. I was upset. I talked to my roommate about it. I prayed about it, and God asked me how am I to respond? And I didn't know what scripture it was. I just knew somewhere in the Bible it said the only way people will, and I'm paraphrasing, but the only way people will know that we're his disciples is if we love one another. And it floored me. You know what I'm saying? And so how, as a Christian body, how do I feel that we're responding? People are responding in so many, everybody's all over the place. But how we should respond is by what the word says. And that's love our neighbors, love one another. That doesn't suggest that we shouldn't fight for social justice. That doesn't suggest that we shouldn't fight for what we believe in. At the same time, it should be done in a way where our enemies and people who do wrong against us to still know who we belong to, if that makes sense.
That makes lots of sense. And I mean, you just, you know, listening to you, I get chills. I don't know about anybody else, but you can hear the passion and the conviction behind what you're saying. So I really appreciate and just really respect you as an artist, and also what you're contributing through your music is absolutely, absolutely amazing. Pastor Jay?
I feel like Dr. Clay has something, so I pass my time for Dr. Clay. I'm practicing. Pass my time.
You know my what? Time
Dr. You're Clay, not, go ahead.
You're unbelievable. Well, I just want to say I commend you for, you know, that word itself is a negative connotation word for anybody that's a black color. And the way you handle it to me was perfect. You know, you could have, you know, went off, as they said, you know, blew a lid.
Let me tell you, I'm going to say this. I'm going to interrupt you really quickly. The only reason why I didn't, and I can just be, I can be real with y'all. The only reason why, because I grew up in Baltimore, Maryland. I grew up in the hood. So that's a part of me that tries to creep up, you know, every now and again.
Be more
1-5 all day. Let me tell you, the only reason why I didn't get at him the way I wanted to was because, number one, I was in one car and he was in another, and the lane that was separating us had a barrier in between it. So when he called me that, he drove off and went left. And so I couldn't, so everything in me wanted to, but I feel that God, you know, allowed it to happen that way just so the song and what's happening in my heart could, you know, manifest, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So that happening to me had nothing to do with me and my feelings. It had to do with more so God allowing that an opportunity to be impactful, you know what I'm saying? So mm-hmm. It's just, God is so mysterious in how he does things. It's like, yeah, I'm gonna test who you are in your heart, you know, in that way, just so you can impact people that you may never even meet. So, yeah, that's.
Well, you know, I'm going to just add on to what you're saying, being led to say this. When I first got called that, I was 5 years old. And I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know that was the day at 5 years old that I knew there was a difference between me and another human being. And I went to my grandmother and I asked her, what does that word mean? And she told me to go grab a dictionary, because that word is still in the dictionary. And it means of an ignorant person, has nothing to do with color. And she said, so are you ignorant? And I was like, no, I'm not. But it made me feel some type of way. And she said, but if you know that, just know that don't let people label you of what they think you should be. You should be who you know you who you are. And now add the Christian side of it, because I was before church. Now adding the Christian side of it, know who you are and whose you are, because if mm-hmm. you step out of line sometimes, because the battle is not ours, It's the Lord's. It's more than just a Yolanda Adams song. I'm just going to say it's really true, because when you step out of line, sometimes you get more of the whooping than the other person.
Absolutely.
So, and sometimes I heard this sermon from a preacher here in Vegas. He says, hard to hate somebody you pray for.
Mm. Yes, absolutely.
I just had to put that out. I was glad to say that. Go ahead, Dr. Clay.
No. You know, I'm thinking about what you said, and I think that the whole problem with the word of someone that is not of color calls you that particular word, it makes anybody a little upset, because first of all, it's almost like they're cursing you in so many different ways.
Absolutely.
And not only I'm born on the west side of Chicago, so I was always around black, you know. But you know, to know that even in Chicago, if you go on the north side, you're treated a different kind of way. You know, the schools, the school of music and stuff like that. You don't get the opportunity that if I was another color on my skin, I would have gotten to the conservatory school, but instead I wasn't. So I didn't get a chance to have that opportunity. And it's for so many reasons. So that word alone is such a negative impact on a whole lot of people. But like you said, if you're not that, then, you know, you don't have to really entertain the thought. I mean, you can call me what you want to call me, but I know who I am. Yeah. And so I just want to commend you for that and the song, because God allowed you to have something, a greater opportunity to go greater than and bigger and larger and wider to many people outside of that one individual.
Yeah.
That was
the whole, I want to commend you also, because I know myself, and I would have followed the person. I just want to be honest and just, you know, I know other people, I thank the Lord, those who are saved out there. But knowing myself, I would have followed them home, because I'm half Caribbean and half crazy. But thank the Lord for deliverance. Amen.
You missed the Canadian part. I was going to say
and I'm Canadian also. Oh. Shout out to Drake. Side note, shout out to the Lakers also. Can we just shout out to the Lakers right now?
Yes, sir. So
I'm going to let y'all know.
God for the
y'all enjoy it now. Enjoy it now.
We thank God for the hands
because,
of LeBron.
Because LeBron in the name of Jesus, the Warriors. Ah, Shabbat. Okay.
But it's we'll not about the Warriors right the now. Vengeance. It's about the Lakers. And we want to thank God.
Yeah.
We want to thank the Lord.
Yeah, let me tell you, we poured it out.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah. Now let me get back on topic.
Yes.
Hey, you got fined $5. I'm just going to throw that out.
I just want to say we thank God for the Lakers. And we've already talked about it. I am a fan, ride or die, through thick or thin. Through Magic
awesome.
Johnson and all of his trials and tribulations. I was there when you talked about us.
That's awesome.
See? Yes, sir.
That's so awesome. Right. Shabbat for the Lakers.
I'm celebrating until the next season. Until
as
we get
you
that.
Should.
We get the chip next year, too.
As you should, huh? Because he's a good God, 24/7.
This interview was fun, everybody. This is like men started talking. No, I'm kidding. I know this is like men. Shout out to, I'm in sportsmanship and all that good stuff. Shout out to the Lakers. You know, we couldn't get all the championships, you know, but it's okay.
Okay.
Congratulations, LeBron and them.
And we celebrate.
And celebrate Los Angeles.
We celebrate.
Lakers.
Okay.
We bless the Lord.
But how about them Raiders? I'm just
hallelujah.
Say.
The Raiders and the Lakers. Now listen.
I love it, man.
Will, it to me it's obvious you're a PK. I you know, you can just tell just your language, growing up in church. I just want to know, and I kind of want to put you on the spot because I just want to hear it. What's your favorite hymn? And you can sing it if you want to.
Let me see. What's my favorite hymn? That's a good question. There's just so many. There's so many. I like 'Tis So Sweet. Definitely love 'Tis So Sweet.
Okay. I won't make you sing it.
Well, I would. It's 11 o'clock here.
Yeah, that part.
You know what I'm saying? And yeah. And the thing is, I would have to get on my keyboard, and I just don't want to, you know, my roommate.
What?
He said he won't act up at 11 o'clock. That's what he said. Yeah. Yeah, act up.
How many instruments do you play?
Well, I play piano. Okay, so I've mastered the piano and organ. Now I can play a little bit of about all of them, but just to get an idea out, you know what I'm saying? So I'm actually trying to pick up the guitar and, like, you know, do a little more with that. But
amen.
Yeah,
that's dope. Mm-hmm. So one thing I would say is, let's ask the question. We're going to ask this question. So for future producers, what would you be telling? Actually, for everything you do, from a musician to singer to producer, give a nugget to each one of those fields of what you've learned, of what you would give to the next generation for them to know. So as a musician, what would you tell someone? As a singer, what would you tell someone? And as a producer, what would you tell someone? Because with you having all that background and all the research time and hours spent to master your craft, I know you got gems and I know you got some knowledge on what you would want to pass the next person, so that they can, you know, not have to follow so many bumps on the road and they get some wisdom and some knowledge.
Absolutely. So I'll start with the musician, because I just know that. My advice to all musicians is, number one, practice. Like, if God is giving, I heard somebody say this, God's gift to us is our talent. Our gift to him is what we do with it. You know, mm-hmm. what I'm saying? And our growth, you know what I'm saying? So all practice, and also master your instrument. But when you play music, focus on playing the music even more than your instrument. You know what I'm saying? Because when you're playing with the band, it's not necessarily about the one, but it's about the one connecting with another one, making it one sound. Mm-hmm. So, you know, play your music, play the music more than your instrument, but master your instrument. That's the first thing that I would tell musicians. Singers, it's okay to be you, you know what I'm saying? Because as a singer myself, right? Because I didn't start out singing, but there are so many other singers that I just feel are very, very skilled. And it could be intimidating, you know, when you're, when you kind of get into that whole comparison thing. But if your thing isn't runs,
come on now.
You know what I'm saying? Because think about, like, okay, think about some of the
you
big
spoke artists. That, Doc. I just had to stop you on that.
Let's talk about it.
Doc. Oh, man. That's powerful what you just said in the name of Jesus. I just want to put my Baptist voice into that, because what you said was, be you. Don't be somebody else that you've heard on, you know, on the radio. Be you, because you have we all have different gifts. And absolutely. Even inside that same criteria of singing, we have different gifts. Some people could hit you know, Alicia Keys. Some people could hit a Toni Braxton. Some people could hit a Luther. Some people can hit Peebo Bryson. But they can't hit them all. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what gives a singer his identity, when he knows the pocket. Like the musicians say, stay in that pocket, you know?
It's a pocket for all of us, let me tell you. It's a pocket for all of us. Once you find it, stay in it. Find your niche. Like, I think of it, and I hope I'm not going all the way in the deep. And this really goes for everybody. But, you know, I have a song right now that's for my next record that I'm working on called Be Myself. And one of the lines is, out of 7 billion, God gave me my own DNA, right? Mm-hmm. Out of 7 billion people in the world, he's given all of us our own DNA and our own fingerprint. So whatever your DNA is, and whatever your talent and your gift is, whether it's singing, whatever, it should match your DNA, because it's that unique. You know what I'm saying? And it's okay to be that. It's okay to be exactly who God is created you to be. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, when you think of the biggest artists, like the, think of any, like the biggest artists in the world, they weren't running all over the place, but whatever they had, you know, the world was able to appreciate it because they were uniquely them. You know what I'm saying? So, and I had to challenge myself, you know, with that too, because you can, you know, comparison is a killer. You know, I hear, you know, like my, like a lot of my friends, you know, Daryl Walls, shout out to Jabari Johnson, you know, Jonathan McReynolds, and these guys that people, you know, they admire, you know what I'm saying, for what they do. They do it very well, but I also do what I do very well as well. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's just like, just be yourself and be okay with it. Producers, and this is the thing that I'm learning, because I've been producing for a long time. It just hasn't been on paper, but mm-hmm. I've been producing for a long time. And even in the, as I made it official, you know, recently, I've realized that, okay, I can have an ear for whatever an art, if an artist gives me a song, right, I can create whatever I want to create with that song. But my assignment as a producer is number one to, if God has given an artist a certain way that the song is supposed to go, is my job is to do the best of my ability, create that sound that was originally given to them. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And so I can't create and I can't produce a song the way I would want to hear it produced. I have to carry, you know, what God has given them and just bring light to it. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of producers kind of get selfish and say, like, you know, if an artist doesn't like a certain thing that they're doing, of course it's like a partnership, but, you know, art, you know, producers say, like, well, I feel like it should be this way just because I like it. It's like, no, like, the sound that God has given the artist to produce is my job to bring it to light. You know what I'm saying? So all of this in the name of servanthood.
Right.
I love it. I know the time, you know, we're coming up on the time, but I want to ask you, when you were talking about music and singing and not sounding like anyone else, to me, looking at your musicianship, there's like literally a sound right now. So I hear Jabari Johnson, Daryl Walls, Jonathan Nelson, Jonathan McReynolds, a lot of those people who I would view as your colleagues in ministry.
Mm-hmm.
So what I want to know is, how do you glean from those people? Like you said, PJ Morton is one of your heroes. And,
absolutely.
And I can hear the musicality, but I can still hear Will McMillan.
Absolutely.
How do you maintain your individuality without trying to sound like someone else? And I ask that not just for you, but we live in a world of I love gospel music and I love mm-hmm. all of it. But we have a lot of people who are
not the same.
Kimberell, Karen Clark, mm-hmm. you know, even Marvin Winans. Like just a lot of, and I don't want to say copycats because imitation is the greatest form of flattery. But how do you maintain your individuality, and what do you say to those who are seeking to find their voice?
Everyone has a go-to. You know what I'm saying? Like, everyone has, if you're going to be a great, you got to follow those who are great. You know what I'm saying? You put yourself in a bad position if you only have one person, because, you know, you'll only try to sound like that person. But my thing is, my advice is to study people. You know what I'm saying? Study people, but study all of them. Like, I have, so PJ Morton is one of them. I listen to a lot of Earth, Wind & Fire. I listen to a lot of Debash. I listen to James Taylor, Bruce Hornsby, Sting, a lot of people that are in, you know, but at the end of the day, I'm failing as an artist and as a producer and as a music creator if I'm emulating them. Mm-hmm. I can be inspired, you know what I'm saying? Because all of us have inspirations. You look at PJ, Stevie Wonder was one of his biggest inspirations, but along with something, of course, you know, Stevie had his, you know, I mean, you look at Michael Jackson, James Brown was his biggest inspiration.
Right.
You know, and But at the same time, it's like when you saw those individuals, they still maintain, you know, their individuality. And that's what you know, although I have all of these inspirations, in a way they all kind of make up who I am. But as I said before, what none of them have is my DNA. So my DNA is with that inspiration is what comes out. You know what I'm saying? And that's God-given. God allows us to, in our journey, to be inspired by so many things, no matter what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, what comes out of you is what's supposed to.
Gotcha.
Right.
That's good. You voting this year?
Oh, absolutely.
So with that being said, segue, go ahead. Make sure you go out there and vote. If you're voting by mail-in, I'm just wanted to give that good old information to make sure you sign the back of your ballot. Make sure that you do not mark anything outside of the bubbles that you're supposed to mark, because you do not want your ballot to be invalid. Ooh, that rhymes. You don't want your ballot to be invalid. Hashtag that, somebody. Hashtag that. So make sure you go. Make sure you go ahead and vote. Voting here in Nevada starts in this Saturday for early voting in booths. They're getting the booths ready, but a lot of people have already received their mail-in ballot. So make sure you go and sign your ballot, turn in your ballot. There is places where drop-offs are. So if you do not trust that your mail people going to take your ballot where it's supposed to go, there are drop-offs so that you can take it to an authorized drop-off spot. There are places, guess what? Like my professor would say, RTDT. What'd that mean? Read the dang thing. Meaning that there's a lot of places for you to be able to make sure that your vote counts, but it's going to take some reading and knowing your state of officials of where everything is. Because all the information is out there. Every Secretary of State for the every state across this nation has put their directions. Read it. Know where they are. You should know them better than a lot of people, so that you could get your vote in there for it to count. Make sure your vote's counted. Your voice matters. Segue by voting. I don't know. I didn't get sponsored by nobody. I just want people to go out there and vote. And then I want to put this out here too. I want y'all, there's still enough time. Everybody, I've been saying this since the primaries of Nevada. And y'all, if you know where I'm about to go with this, you're about to know where I go with this. Just let you know, judges are up for election. Mm-hmm. Learn who your judges are. Because a lot of times we do not know who they are. We do not know who our school board is. We don't know who our state representatives are. And the state representatives make your law. The judges that you're going to see for child support, for crime, for whatever you're going to see them way before you see a president. So you need to know them too. Because these people make very dramatic changes in your community, in your city, and it deals with you personally. So make sure that you know who they are. They're candidates. They have bios, thick bios. Make sure you go read them so that you know who you're voting for, so you're not playing the high school tests where you're saying CCCAAA and all that good stuff, because that's why stuff hasn't changed, because we have to know who is doing what and what they do. Amen.
Can I just say one thing to that too? This morning I was actually watching one of my friends, do her voting, whatever. And so if she didn't know who a specific person was, she actually Googled them on the spot. I thought that was very, very, very good. So that's something that I'll make sure I do when I when I do that. It's like, if you don't know who somebody is, Google them. See what they're about. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, that'll give you a better judgment on who to. So, yeah, she's on here too. Shout out to her.
Shout out to her, because, you know, it's knowledge is power, and you know what they're about, what they stand for, because they wrote about it. And you can be able to see more about them. And Google is your friend.
Yep.
Absolutely.
One more time. Google is your friend. Hopefully we get sponsored by Google. Throw us some dollars out there. Anyway. Right? So with that being said, shout out to all the Google. So one thing I would like to say is, Will, I would want you to just tell us a little bit about your future projects, because I know the time is getting there, and you said it's almost midnight, so I'm going to be time conscious with that, because on the West Coast it's only 8. I'm still going to watch my stories before going to sleep. But I know you ain't got that time.
You watching your stories?
I'm going to watch my stories, all my shows on the DVR. Because I've been gone from my house for a few days. So I know I have time to do that, but you cannot. So with that being, with time permits, I would want you to just say all your future projects. And I'm interested in this, so I know somebody else is interested in it. Your production company, how can someone get in contact for your productions and to partner with you and what you look for? Those two things. And then we're going to go ahead and close out.
Absolutely. So I'm working on a project right now. And I'm figuring out the name. I'm gonna throw two of the names out there. So just give you something to pray for. The EP I'm working on is gonna be entitled Hard Reset. That's one of the names, or Who I Really Am, dealing with the whole DNA.
I like the second one.
Yeah. So the first name was because a lot of the inspiration from these songs was, you know, birthed out of the pandemic happening. I feel like God put us all in a, you know, time to like reset our thinking and kind of shift us. Shout out to Nicole, my manager. She kind of hit me with that a little bit.
Shout out to Nicole.
Yeah, she kind of inspired that.
Or
Who I Really Am, dealing with the DNA. So we'll see. It might be a little bit of both. I might deal with one and two. So that's that. Working on a Christmas song that should drop at the end of November. I'm excited about that. It'll be my first Christmas song. And yeah, the plan is, and something else to pray for, the plan is to drop a song or two for the next 8 months. So just content. Just, you know, just continue, you know, to be a flow of it. And then at the end of that, we're going to try to do something live next year. So, you know, kind of keep us in your prayers about that, because we're, you know, we're in planning. I gave a whole lot I probably shouldn't have, but, you know, there it is. So,
hey, now it's out there. So it's already manifesting. Just throw that out there.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
And I just want to interject. I think people need to kind of realize, like, what's happening right now. You're about to blow up. So everybody remember this interview, remember this time, click like and share. If you've never heard of Will McMillan before, go to iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, everything, because I feel like by next year, don't forget us, you know, you're going to be a whole nother
family.
Yeah, you're definitely
to my line. He beat me to my life. No, I wasn't talking about we'll
good. Like, we're that's
family.
Good.
Hold on, we is family.
We're family.
We cousins.
I'm supposed to do my Uncle Phil housewarming.
No, he connected. He connected.
But shout out to E1. Shout out to Nicole. Shout out to you.
Shout out to classic creative.
Yeah.
Artistry. Definitely CCA with Nicole. Thank God for Nicole. That's the sis. I really appreciate her. And shout out to E1 and Omega and Gina and all of them over there. They're really doing some great things in the midst of the pandemic. They was coming out with great projects before the pandemic, and just seeing the drive, you know, including you, Will, with having you guys having some great things. So I know for sure that God has some very big doors opening. I like both of your titles, Reset, because, you know, everybody reset in this season. And I could even include myself, so that we could be able to come back refreshed and repurposed to know what we're doing is what we're supposed to be doing. Because a lot of times before the pandemic, we was doing a whole lot of moving, but everything wasn't what God wanted us to do. And then knowing who we are is why God reset us. See, I got tired. I'm a preacher. That's what happens. And then he reset us so that we can know who we are, so we can invest in what our purpose is, so we could walk accordingly on what God created us to be, because I was created. Yes, I love that song. I want to hear that song. I was created. Okay, amen. Yeah, so with that being said, I just want you to know that, and just speak this a little bit, just God wants you to stay focused and to remember the servitude, you know, because what, you know, it says wait on the Lord. A lot of people forget, what is a waiter? A waiter is a servant. They serve during the time of waiting for the next opportunity to open up for them. So just continue to serve, continue to go through those doors while still having that humble attitude, because one thing is, when the way that you treat others is the way other people will serve you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's good. So I just want to know that. And with that being said, I still have, I'm not stopping. God, I hear you. Amen. So somebody out there wants to know this. How can they reach out for your production? Because I know I got, so I'm going to let y'all know I got about like 50 artists hitting the Anointed Radio for music play, share, you know, and I'm doing distribution. You know how to put that E40. Distribution. And I have all these artists, but you know, one thing I am big about is helping artists. Right? You know, anybody knows me for real, I'm about helping artists, giving you the knowledge, giving you the resource, giving you the person that you might need, if it's a PR person, if it's a producer, if it's whatever. So for knowledge base for all the artists on here, shoot, for including myself, I'm not going to be selfish and not include myself in it too. How can we reach out to you, Mr. Will, for production?
Well, for sure. My website right now is under construction. I'm working on that. So that is something that will be in the near future that people can reach out. But for now, you can reach out to me on my email. And that's willmband@gmail.com. Also, my social media, I answer literally, and I probably shouldn't, but I answer all of my DMs.
Be careful now. You know, yeah, going to slide into the DMs.
I answer all of
the Delilah spirit out of your DMs.
Delilah spirit.
Speak against them right now.
Distraction.
Distraction. Listen, everybody. Serious inquiries only.
Yeah,
and young
yeah.
ladies. Keep your hands to yourself.
Be nice Amen. And hopeful. Amen. Amen.
Yeah, no, man.
Professional
hey,
inquiries.
Music.
Listen.
And business, please.
It's gospel music, but I know how these young ladies are in the gospel industry, too. I'm just going to leave it at that.
Amen.
Serious inquiries only,
oh,
people.
Oh, my Lord. Yeah.
That
yeah.
part.
But I answer, and I also know how to, you know, it's a block button too. You know how to do that. So
praise God for block. That's the thing.
I can do that. And there's also a restrict button, there's a mute button. There's a lot of it. There's a lot of it. God is giving us a He's providing
for it.
So we're good.
Have you had to use your block button a lot? I'm just calling. Have you had to use the block button a lot, or are you good?
And it's become my best friend at times. So
okay.
It's the secret of block.
You hear that, folks out there?
Restriction and mute.
And mute.
All of the above. But no, so, you can reach out to me, you know, via DM or email. And also, I just got a business line as well. So I'll put that number on there, you know, for that as well. So you can reach out to me, you know, through those things, and you know, we can, you know, make something happen.
Word. Amen. So one thing I want to just say, you already said it. We are family.
Absolutely.
So that being said, do not shy from any project here at Anointed Radio. We do not forget you. You know, it's not a one and done. If you have something happen, you be like, hey, bro, I need you to post my new song, play my new song. We got you, because you spent the time. You plant that seed to develop the familyhood of having us be developing partners together, because you believed enough to come on Anointed Radio, you know, and actually share with us your great testimony, your talent. And spend late night out, late in the midnight out.
So,
you know, because it's late over there. You know, you better than me. Amen.
It's all good. It's all good.
Still not the latest though, because Juanita Francis is still the latest because she was in the UK and it was like 3 o'clock in the morning, and I was like, okay, she is dedicated. You know?
Yeah, yeah. No, shout out to Juanita. That's my homie. I love her. I love her dad. Her whole family. I love them.
Yeah, she got the record. No one's beat her record yet. 3 o'clock in the morning. You know, one time I thought we lost it. I was like, I'd be asleep. And she's like, no, I'm here. And I was like, okay.
That's
what I'm talking about. That's dedication. But one thing I wanted to say is we're here to be able to help you out any way that we can. Any projects, this won't be the first and last interview. Definitely come on for some release and new music coming out into the world. And I just want you to know that we are here because we believe that united we can change. you know, especially the body, because unity brings change, right? But united, we can bring a change that actually stands, because when the body of Christ comes together, there is a power that could be able to get back to the original mandate that we're all mandated to do. And that is to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ, because there's somebody out there that's looking for love. There's somebody out there that's looking for hope. There's somebody out there that's looking for the way maker. And it is our obligation to be able to share our testimony, to be able to minister to others so that we can be able to help somebody else, because it was somebody that took time to help you. Yes, I remember mine. Amen. I remember my moment, and I remember how powerful that one moment was. It wasn't a sermon. It was just somebody that cared enough to tell me about Jesus and worry about my well-being. So amen. With that being said, I want you to just say thank you for coming on once again. And say one more time where your social media, so for everybody to get on the record.
Yeah, for sure. So you have Instagram, that's my name, Will McMillan, with three I's. You have Twitter, The Willin Band, Facebook, Willin Band, and that's it. No Snapchat, no MySpace. I'll probably get
MySpace. Not MySpace. Ooh, what's that? Black Planet? I'm like, hey, not Black Planet. You know, my aim is Singer Boy 90. You know, throw that back out.
Oh, wow.
Throwback.
Those were the days.
Man. If, I have to throw that little sub tweet to this. Do you know we played MySpace? MySpace was giving us job quality skills of teaching us how to code. You know how much a coder makes entry level? He makes six figures. And we disrespected MySpace and said, Tom, we go on to Facebook. But he taught us how to make backgrounds, put music videos on websites. Yeah. He was teaching us how to be a website designer. And we was ungrateful, y'all. We got lazy and was just like, I just wanted to take a whole bunch of pretty pictures and put small captions on it.
Yep.
Anyway, shout out.
Facebook was smart. They're like, we're not going to let y'all Tom us. We're going to buy Instagram.
That's what they did.
That's true.
And, you know, Instagram is they took over. So they're like, we learned from Tom. So Tom was a help in a sense.
Right. Tom was the prophet to show that what can happen if they slip on their Mackin. I've just thought that out there, because they got that amp record distribution. If you're looking as an artist, saying that out there, if you're an artist out there, we have 20 slots for new upcoming artists that's looking for a distribution deal. And throw that out there, distribution. Ooh, you know, tell me where to go. You could go to Amp Records on Instagram and be able to see this distribution where we are already distributing. And shout outs to all the people already on there. We have the Voices of Antioch. That is my old choir that just came out. Go check it out. The Voices of Antioch. Their album cover is called It's Your Season. Throwback 2005 good choir worship songs. Y'all gonna get taken back by some of them songs. You're gonna be like, oh, I need that for my soul. And then we have Dr. Clay's song that we have coming out. And yeah, I got a project out there too. Distribution's working. So with that distribution coming, y'all go ahead and hit us up. And then we'll gonna be able to start making some productions too. So you got distribution and a producer. Why you ain't got a song out? All right, that's what I was going to just say. All right, so with that being said, I just want to thank everybody for spending time with us. We thank you, Mr. Will McMillan, for all the things that you share with us. Continue to stay in touch. And my word of wisdom before we go, I always have to call my good old brother, and my brother's name is Cletus. Oh, no, he didn't. Okay.
Oh, I thought he wasn't coming on.
I was going to dock him today. I was going to dock Cletus pay. I'm serious. He don't get paid nothing, but he was going to get docked. If Chris was on, that's why he said we were supposed to vote him out, but we ain't voting out Cletus. Cletus is a good old and faithful. Amen. Mm. So with that being said, I just want to leave some knowledge. Make sure you go vote. Make sure your voice is counted. It's only a few more weeks, and a whole lot of changes will happen. So make sure you go vote to make a difference in your community. It isn't just presidency. There's some laws getting pushed out there too. So if you don't know them, you got time to go read those laws that they're trying to propose, because we, I know in the state of Nevada, we have 5 new laws being proposed to get put into place. And one of them, all of them are going to affect you personally. So with that being said, make sure you learn the laws, read them, read the books. Reading is fundamental. It teaches you a lot, because if you learn it for yourself, nobody can ever take it away from you. So make sure you go vote. Make sure you love on somebody. And with what I just came back from, if you got any type of beef right now with a family member or friend, go squash it, because tomorrow's not promised. It shouldn't be to a time where we come together because of a tragic time. It's the only time you talk to somebody.
Wow.
You got time to go speak to that person. Use it, because when you don't, that's it. And it's important to remember that, because I can say 2020, a lot of people's leaving out of here. And with that being said, don't have no grudge with nobody, because you don't know if you'll be able to talk to them tomorrow. And most of the time, that thing that you petty about, the thing that you tripping about, it ain't even that big. Especially, it's, most of the time, it's a miscommunication.
Yeah.
So with that being said, you know, how could we, I got God's just saying to say simply this, how could we ask him to forgive us if we can't forgive others? That's biblical, y'all. Just have to throw that out there. So sometimes we got to go back to the basics and study ourselves approved by being good in God's sight, not man's sight. So stay safe. Wash your hands. Wear your mask. Do all the stuff that you got to do. Take your sea moss, your black seed oil. I'm giving y'all this for free. This is for free game right here. And your elderberry and your vitamins. And stay up on those things. And we will see you next week. Make sure you go subscribe to all of our podcast platforms, iHeartRadio, Pandora, everything but Tidal, because Jay-Z be tripping. I'm going to have Dr. Clay make that shirt. Jay-Z be tripping. At least on the podcast side, because I'm on Tidal on my music, so I can't complain, so I need to stop saying that. Sorry, Jay-Z, my bad. Anyway, that being said, we'll see you guys next week. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
God bless.
Thank you, Will.